I'm warmed up. it's just amazing to me, and I guess not surprising, that Mr. Gillum and I are true blue Democrats because our platforms are almost identical. I mean, so much so that I was stunned by what he was saying. I mean, my brochure is back there. I wish you would take one and look at it. It is almost identical. This is what a Democrat believes. Let's give the future mayor, the future governor, another hand. So I have spoken to this group a couple of times already. I recognize quite a few people in the room. There are just a few people I don't recognize, just a few, because I have spoken to the Clay County Democratic Executive Committee, and I have spoken to the Clay County Democratic Women's Club, of which I am a member of both Unilogical County. I'm from Gainesville, Florida, a little girl from Gainesville, Florida, born and raised, as they say, also educated. I'm a double gator. I don't want to repeat all of that because I've told the story so many times, but for some of you, I must tell you that I am a lifelong educator. You have to know that because it is my life's blood. I have been a teacher. I have been a counselor, peer counselor. You might not know what that is. That's for at-risk children, teenagers. And I've been a diagnostic placement specialist because my field was special education. So I consider myself a specialist in education. I've been an assistant principal, a principal. I have owned my own educational consulting company, of which I still do pro bono work for people in my community. I'll tell you something else I didn't tell you before about myself is that I'm the firstborn of six children of a teenage mom. I am not necessarily first-generation college grad because my paternal family all had college degrees. No one on my mother's side had one. I was raised by my grandmother, God rest her soul, who believed education was the change agent. So she put me in an insurance endowment the day I was born for education. And so even though it wasn't a whole lot of money when I got ready to go to college, it was already there. The idea was already planted there. I knew I was going to college. I was not going to just script this point. My grandmama taught me a few things. She was a smart one. I want to tell you a few of those things because even though she couldn't read and write, she could out-count, out-think all of us. And she was the typical character from the movie The Help. You know that movie. But she always worked for very prominent people. So she had a lot of goals. But one of the things she taught me is your word is your bond. Your word is your bond. Whatever you say, you must do. If it's worth doing, it's worth doing well. That taught me the level of commitment that I have to anybody I tell I will do something to this very day. Don't look a gift horse in the mouth. Y'all know what that means. Now, this one, I'm not so sure, but I'll tell you what it means to me. Give Caesar what belongs to Caesar. Because we got some legislators today in trouble because of that. To me, that means pay people what you owe. Only take what you work for. These are ethics that I have lived by, and I still live by them today. I need you to know that. I also helped to raise my five siblings, and today they still give me maternal respect. I have one daughter and one son, 12 years apart. What was I thinking? My daughter was easy until she turned 14. She's a straight-A student. She's also a Gator grad. She turned 14 and I thought she had been invaded by body snatchers. I don't know who she became. Some of you understand. My son I must have been in labor a month. He stopped me from having children. He, at three, started showing signs of dyslexia. And at school age, became ADHD. First time I had heard that term, there is no program for that, and I am a special educator. I believe I'm a specialist in education for a reason. And I'm telling you this story so you know what's going to happen to me if I get elected. There will be no second-class education. My son is also a college graduate, a fine young man, raising a family, independent, good thinker. I'm so proud of him. I'm more proud of him today than I am my daughter. Now, I do want to tell you about some of the things on my platform that Mr. Gillum has already told you about. But we Democrats have got to figure out what happened in this last election. Analyze what are the conditions in which we create this situation and do something about it. One of those problems is income gap. The income gap. People are mad. People got to work three jobs. They can't raise their children. Who's going out with an ADHD kid if they're working three jobs? Three jobs it takes. So they need a livable wage. I don't know if you mentioned that. Good, thank you for coming. We need well-paying jobs at a livable wage. The income gap in Gainesville alone is the fourth largest gap in the nation. Do you know how small Gainesville is? It's the fourth largest gap in the nation. Florida has the fourth largest gap in the nation. We've got to change that, Democrats, if we expect to see a change in 2020. And like Mr. Gillum said, we gotta turn some seats blue to make that change. Because the top 1% is so much farther to the bottom 99%, their income is almost four times that of the people at the bottom. They don't want to change. We've got to change by voting. We've got to turn the seats. There's no other way to do that. And now you know about education. If we don't invest in high quality schools, Betsy DeVoe is gonna have her way. Now Betsy DeVoe has just thrown out 72 federal regs about special education. Now, you just heard me tell you how I feel about special education. There are now no protections if she gets her way for special education children. Children who need help. There will be no regulations for them. I don't know what she's planning to do about that. Maybe she's really never been to a school where children need help. Because you know, in charter schools, you can kick them out. I mean, maybe you don't. When a kid enrolls in a charter school, they get the money for the kid. And when they can't handle that kid, they kick them out. Money's gone. Kids got to go back to public school. Public school has very little money, but they are required by law to handle the kid. We've got to stop this fast-paced roller coaster ride to privatization by charter schools. Yes. I don't know how we're going to do it. We got to flip these seats. And that's why I'm running. I want to give you an option. That is why I'm running. The other things on my platform you might be interested in